one second. You know what I'm saying? Just one microsecond. Then I'm sorry, we're going to have to retire you. You're going to find yourself in Invercargill. Coaching backpackers on how to pour a beer and make a coffee. That's what the world economy has become, as we know. So, woo! Especially for the people that were born in another century. Come on, mate, have your moment in the sun. Freaking hell, get on with it, man. He hasn't done anything yet and you're cheering already. You Kiwis are so sweet-natured and so kind. He's got all the moves. He's like Jacinta without a Nobel Prize nomination. No, I didn't mean it. That's actually interesting because she is really pretty good from all perspectives, but in your own home, if you don't deliver on the things that you promised, then you get into trouble. That's the way politics works, I guess. So, for those of you that were born not in another century, you may know that once upon a time, children, like some little fella up there, used to work in coal mines. And women were considered second-rate citizens who weren't allowed to vote or own property. And people of a different colour were persecuted and beaten to death and locked up and forgotten about forever. And people were not allowed to organise themselves as collectives to stand in the might and the face of economic and political power. But once they could do that, once they could organise themselves so that the will of the people was seen to benefit most of the people for most of the time, things started to change. Hallelujah, Blue Sky Mine. Thank you, Dan. So,
thank you, Dan.
A selfie, really?
Thank you, Dan.
He did well. He did really well. Mate, you killed it.